Hey guys, welcome back to my Catchy name. It's me, Ella, and today I'm going to be going over my 2019 goals. I didn't do very good. And I'm going to be talking about my 2020 goals. Craft related. Hey guys, welcome back. So I watched my 2018 to 2019 goals video and I took notes. I didn't really do that good. But in my defense, I didn't have them where I could see them and be reminded of them. So this year I'm actually going to print out, I'm going to make it cute and put like some pictures on it or something. little list of my 2020 goals for No Catch Name and crafty stuff. And put it somewhere where I can see it almost all the time. And be able to maybe achieve my goals a little bit better because I didn't do good at all this year. But it's been on that video. I didn't even have it written down anywhere. I had to go back to the video just to refer to it. But I got it listed right here on my computer, and I'm going to read them off and tell you how I did. No particular order, although I think they are in the right order from the video because I was watching the video and writing it down. But one of my goals for 2019 was to make the Grinchmas throw, which is a corner-to-corner afghan that I've had downloaded for years and wanted to make. I didn't make it. I didn't even start to make it. I wanted to, and I still want to. It's actually going to go into my next list of goals for 2020, because I really love that blanket and I want to put it in my living room. I just haven't had the time, and I haven't bought the yarn for it. That's really the only thing that's stopping me, is I haven't figured out how much of each color I need and bought it. I might actually have it. I don't know. My second goal for 2019 was to make a Christmas countdown, like an advent kind of, for Jessie. And I was given a pattern in 2018, I think. Yeah, the year before last. Or, you know, this year. to make one, and I would love to make that. It's another corner to corner piece. Ugh, I hate doing corner to corner, but I don't know if I want to do that. I don't know if I'm gonna carry that goal into 2020 with me. I might make it still, but I was gifted a sewn the pattern for a sewn one, and I did make it this year. You would have seen it in vlogs and stuff, and I did successfully make that because it was not as much work as like a crochet one would be. So we'll definitely be using that forever. And that'll probably become a keepsake for Jesse when he gets older or has family of his own. So I don't know if I need to make a Christmas one, but who knows, I might still crochet that one, but it's not gonna be on my goals. Okay, my third goal was to make stockings for each of us. That did not happen at all. Well, I didn't even make one stocking. I didn't even make one to enter into the fair. Did I? Let me think. Maybe I did. Yes, I did. But it wasn't like a stocking I was gonna keep, because all the crochet stockings that I've found are really small. They're not like really big enough for you to put stuff in. But I did get gifted a beautiful hand sewn one from Angelia, and that's my stocking now. From now on. Well, she didn't hand sew it, but you know, she made it herself with a machine. But you know what I mean, she handmade it. And then I bought Jesse a big giant one. We didn't use that yet this year, because by the time I bought it was too late. I already had all his stuff bought, his gifts. But next year we're gonna use that one for him. And then I just have to get one for Devin. And what I'm thinking about doing is seeing if I can get Angelia to make me another one that's similar to mine, but different fabric, so that they don't, you know, we don't get mixed up. But I know mine's the one with teddy bears, so then he needs to get one that doesn't have teddy bears on it. But that way we have all hand-sewn, or, you know, homemade, or, what am I talking about? What are they called? Stockings? so that it is more special that way. Because if I made crochet stockings, I'd have to line them so that stuff wouldn't poke through the holes. And that's just a lot of work that I don't want to do. All right, my fourth goal for 2019 was to enter more into the fair. I did not do that at all. I entered less in the fair, actually, because I procrastinated and was busy doing other things and didn't work on fair projects. I have already got fair projects running around in my brain right now for 2020 fair. So hopefully this year I will do that. So that's probably a goal that is going to continue to go over into 2020. My fifth goal for 2019 was to make two blankets for our family members. One was my mom. Something just fell in the living room. And one was my sister. I did not make those. I didn't even start to make those. I completely forgot that I wanted to make those. I know what blankets they are, and I might still make them, but I'm not going to put it on my list because I ain't got time for it. There's always other things I want to crochet. And my sister and my mom, they're both yarn worthy. But I did give my sister a blanket last year. It wasn't the one she asked for, but it was one that I made her. And she liked it a lot. It's on her couch. And my mom gets all kinds of crochet stuff from me all the time anyways. So I don't think either of them will care if I didn't make them those blankets. Number six. Am I on number six? One, two, three. Number six was I wanted to destash my yarn, which I don't know if I destashed. but I did use only for my stash. I don't think I've bought much yarn at all this year. At least the second half of this year, I haven't bought any. I haven't bought any yarn in months. I can't think. I'm trying to think. Maybe the only yarn I've bought recently was from, like, the thrift store. I got a lot gifted to me this year, and I do appreciate that. But I have way too much yarn now. I've been giving it away to a lot of people, slowly, a little bit, a little bit. The girl that I babysit, I gave her a whole bunch of yarn for Christmas. And actually, one of my goals for 2020 is going to be involving my stash. So we'll talk about that in a minute. But I don't think I de-stashed very good this year. Number 7, I wanted to host a cow, which I did. I hosted a couple cows this year. I know I had the Christmas in July cow, and I had one earlier this year, but I can't remember now what it was. New Year, New You? Was that this year? I think that was this year. So I hosted 2 cows this year, and I have a list of cows that I'm wanting to host this coming year, 2020, but they're a secret until I get all the information, all, you know, until I get everything written down and figure out who might help participate in it and all that kind of stuff. But I'm pretty excited about it, so hopefully that'll be fun. Number 8, I think I wanted to enjoy what I make. I did do a lot better this year at doing that. I frogged a lot of patterns recently, a few months ago, that I just wasn't enjoying, so I just decided to frog them, and I did. There's still one waiting to be frogged. The only reason I haven't frogged it is because it's got embroidery face on it and safety eyes that I gotta pick off of the yarn before I frog it. But it's already out of the project bag and sitting in there waiting for me to frog it. And I'm definitely carrying that one into 2021 because I don't want to waste time working on projects that I don't enjoy. And like commissions, I'm not gonna take commissions for things that I don't want to work on, because I would rather crochet what I enjoy instead of just being in a terrible grumpy mood because it's something I hate. So I'm definitely carrying that one with me. The next one, I forget what number I'm on, was to have at least one video a week. I did fairly good at that this year. There were some weeks I skipped for whatever reason, but for the most part, I have put out a lot of videos this year, so that's good. My goal was to hit 3,000 subscribers, and I surpassed that. I'm at 5,000 and something right now, so that's crazy. I never thought I'd have 100 subscribers, nonetheless, 5,000. And 100 and something, but that's a lot of people, oh my gosh, but that's so cool, and I want to thank you all for that, y'all the ones who did that, not me. And then my last goal for 2019 was to get over 1,000 members in the Facebook group, and right now I think it's 1,500 and something, so I did that, so woohoo. I love the Facebook group, it's so fun to see what everybody shares, and all the pictures and stuff. But yeah, so that was my 2019 goals. I actually did really horrible. I only accomplished a couple of them. But that's okay. That's, you know, the goals are just things you strive towards. Doesn't necessarily mean you're going to get it. All right, so my goals for 2020 is a little bit less than that. There's a few from 2019 that I'm carrying over, and that is the enjoy what I make. I don't want to work on projects that don't make me happy, so I'm just going to enjoy what I make. I do want to de-stash, and what I'm actually going to do is I'm on a craft ban, which isn't that bad because I haven't been buying anything crafty other than bag material lately anyways. So I'm not gonna buy any more yarn, which I have anyways. I'm gonna work for my stash. I've been doing a good job. That scarf and ear warmer that I made recently, and the shawl that I'm working on, and the pattern that I'm designing are all from stash yarns. So I'm just gonna try to keep working for my stash and get it down a whole lot, and maybe get down to just having a couple shelves of yarn. I'm looking over here because we're in my bedroom. I have 2 bookcases of yarn, plus I have 2 in the craft room, plus I have a big box of scrap balls, and then I have a box in the closet full of yarn that was given to me. So I need to work through a lot of this stuff and give away a lot of it and gift it and stuff, and because I want to do other things in my house. I don't want just craft stuff everywhere. I want functional rooms, and I can't really do a lot in the craft room because there's so much stuff everywhere. I do want to continue making videos as often as I can to keep my, you know, content up and the views and all that up, and to keep the channel growing, and you know, just make it a more fun crochet environment. That's why I split my crochet videos from my vlogs. From now on, they're going to be on 2 different channels, so that one channel is just crochet and crafty stuff, and one channel is the personal stuff. I don't really have any goals for making the channel bigger subscription wise, or like the Facebook group bigger member wise. Just it'll grow if it grows, it won't if it won't, I guess. But then I got some other goals right here. One of them is I don't want to buy any more craft supplies, which I just talked about that. But that's for any craft. That's all my crafting other than for making bags with. You know, I got to buy fabric and thread and needles and zippers and interfacing, all that to make bags to sew. That's, you know, a given. And then my other goal was to use my stash up, which I also talked about that already, so I'll skip that. This one is going to be an annoying one. This goal for 2020, I want to finish my big projects that I've had going for a while. And that's the Jada and Stitches folk art calendar blanket, the Jada and Stitches 2017 calendar blanket, the Unraveled Mitten blanket, and my Christmas tree skirt. I want to finish all those this year, and I don't want to start any more big projects like that unless it's for the fair. Like, I do want to make another afghan for the fair this year. I will be starting that eventually when I find the right pattern. I've been looking at some, but I gotta find the right one. So I want to finish all those blankets up and get them gifted to who they're going to, or keep them if I'm keeping them. And then I don't want to start any more big projects because I'm not good at staying committed to big projects. I like little stuff better. So I need to get them out of the way because they're just in a box right now taking up space. I need to finish them and get rid of them. And then my last goal so far, I might make up some more. My last goal is to sell or donate a finished objects, because I have a lot of finished objects that I made that we don't use and they're just sitting around. I have a whole big tote, one of those big ones, of amigurumis left over from my craft fair. And I might do some craft fair this year, but I'm not sure if I will. And right now, you know, we live in a really small apartment and we're not moving anytime soon because we got a lot of debts that we want to pay off. Medical bills and stuff is coming in, and we're still paying for Jesse's broken arm. It's so expensive. But I want to get rid of a lot of stuff that's just sitting around, and those amigurumis are just taking up space. So I thought about putting them on my Etsy shop, but I don't know if people's gonna buy them, and I don't really want to waste time and the money, because it costs money to put stuff on Etsy. Putting things up there, it's not gonna sell. So I could donate them, but I have to make sure they go into people who are older kids and not little kids, because a lot of them have safety eyes and they're not really that safe. They're easy to pluck out if a kid tries hard enough. But yeah, so I think that's pretty much all my goals this year. I'm sure I'll come up with some more, but I got a few more days. Today's the 28th, so I got a few more days to think about it. And then I do also have a bunch of goals for our life, but I'll talk about that in a video on the other channel. But it's going to be like our financial goals and our health goals and stuff like that. But if you're interested in that, that will be linked below the new channel. The new channel is going to be called No Catchy Name Vlogs. I should have named it No Catchy Name Life. Maybe I'll change that. I don't know. But it's because it's not just going to be vlogs. It's going to also be other parts of our life, which is like recipes and stuff like that. I don't know. We'll see. But anyways, this is not that. This is different. I'm getting sidetracked. But it's getting dark. I'm losing my daylight, so I'm going to get off here. I think that's all my goals. So I do want to know from you guys, like, tell me below, what are some of your craft goals for 2020? And even if you had some for 2019, let me know if you did them or if you failed or whatever. Let me know. It's fun to read what other people are wanting to do, and it gives you ideas of how you want to do stuff for yourself. So let me know. And if maybe you know, we have similar goals, we can help each other check up and stay accountable to get them done. I'm going to try to record maybe quarterly, or at least halfway mark, like in the middle of the year, to, you know, see if I've been doing some of these things. I really want to get those blankets done and out of the way, because they're just taking up space and they're just sitting there half finished. All I gotta do is finish them and get rid of them, because I'm not gonna frog them. There's too many ends already woven in to do that. But yeah, so let me know in the comments below what your goals for 2020 are, craft related or not. It's up to you. And I'll see you guys next video. Bye, guys.